Be blessed by the divine. Dear spiritual aspirants, we go to discuss the topic Dasavatar. All religions preach creation theory. They say the God created this universe and living beings all. But Vedatri Maharishi explains the evolution theory. He preaches that the God became the universe. The Almighty evolved, transformed into the living beings. Let's get a short view on this and we go to discuss the topic Dasavatar. According to Vedatri Maharishi's philosophy, he says, beyond the universe, there is an absolute dark space which is boundaryless. It is omnipresent in this universe. It is omniscient, it is all-pervading and all-pervasive, it is permanent, it is called Brahma. This is the God. This almighty absolute dark space has an internal power, it is called self-compressive and surrounding pressure force. By this force, the atoms, the energy particles are created. These energy particles are called as atoms or Akash in Sanskrit. This is the first element in the universe. When these energy particles associate more, they become the air. When more energy particles associate in the air, it is called fire. When the fire and the air join together and they evolve into the water. When the more energy particles join in this water, they become the land. So these are the five elements evolution. This is the evolution of universe philosophy. Okay. Now, where the five elements are called Panchabhutas, where these Panchabhutas are suitably arranged by the consciousness of the Almighty, there automatically the one sense living beings starts to evolve without the seeds. So one sense living being starts the plants, trees, all, and from the one sense, two sense living beings like worm and the others will start evolve. Next, from the two sense, automatically third sense, the ants and termite, etc., this kind of living beings evolve. And from the third, the fourth sense, like a snake and lizard, crab, this kind of living beings evolve. From the fourth sense, the fifth sense living beings like birds and animals, they evolve. From these fifth sense animals, like from monkey, our sixth sense human beings, we evolve from the fifth sense. Then now we research back in this chain, our origin starts from the five Panchabhutas. Further, it starts from the almighty dark space. Okay. Now, we understand that it is very important to know the evolution of universe and the evolution of living beings, which is our history. Okay. Now, we touch the topic Dasavatar. What means Dasavatar? Dasa avatar. Dasa or das in Sanskrit is 10. Avatar means birth or incarnation. It means the 10 incarnation of Lord Vishnu or Lord Narayana. We have to note a point here that before thousands of years ago, our forefathers who lived in this country, they had very much realized the evolution of universe and the evolution of living beings. But they were unable to preach this philosophy to the people because people's culture and their habit and their life were not suitable to receive the knowledge, the wisdom from the forefathers. So they created some stories, and within the stories they preached the evolution of universe and living beings indirectly. So Dasavatar is one of that story. It did not happen actually, but it is a story, but we can know the informations about the evolution of universe, living beings and the almighty power, etc. from this story. Okay, what is the first avatar? The first incarnation of Narayana is the Matsya avatar. Matsya means fish, fish incarnation. The god became the fish in the first avatar. Why they selected the fish in this story is, fish is the oldest living being in this world. Because once upon a time, there was 100% of water in the surface of the earth. Now we see 72% of the water and 28% of the land. But before that, only 100% of water was there. Then that time, what will happen under the land and above the water, above that air and the sunlight, all five panchabhutas are there. So only the living beings can start to evolve from the water only. So they selected the fish. Actually, the fish has five senses. It has up to the ear. So it is a fifth sense living being in the water. But if you research further, it must have come from the fourth sense living being in the water, like a crab or sea lizard, like that. Further, if you go back, three sense and two sense in the sea, the two sense living beings like oyster, from which we take the pearls, the oyster is a two sense living being. Further, if you go back, the first sense living beings is the plants, the small plants under the water of the ocean, we can see. There are so many plants in the land of ocean. They are the first creatures in this world. But why they selected the fish is, fish is very familiar to the all human beings. People cannot see all the plants under the water, but every people know the fish. So they selected the older living being, the creature as fish. The second avatar is the Kurma avatar. Kurma means the turtle or tortoise. That the god became the turtle. By selecting the turtle, our forefathers, they declared that the living beings started to come to the land only from the water. First, now we see how the land, the 28% of the current land started to evolve. As we saw already, all the surface, the 100% of the surface of the earth was fully water, but under the water, a strong land was every time. But now, under the earth, the volcanoes start to erupt. So when they erupt more and more, they throws out the land under and outside the water. Now smaller land comes out and slowly, slowly the volcanoes erupt more and the land comes to the surface of the water. Now the living beings who are living in the water, they try to come to the land. So turtle is the example which can live both in water and land. Now we can understand that the living beings came from the water to the land. I give you a further one example. There is a fish, its name is called mud skipper. You can search in the YouTube or Google, mud skipper, mudskipper. This mud skipper is a fish. If you search the video in the YouTube, you can wonder that this fish will come to the land and it will walk. It will survive in the land and again it will go back to the water. By looking this, you can clearly understand that the living beings, the creatures came from the water to the land. So this is what they selected the turtle. Again, we can get clarified that the turtle is very familiar to the people. So they selected the turtle. But before the turtle, this kind of mud skipper, this kind of fish, many living beings are there. So in every selection, they use the familiar and older species in this world. Next, third avatar is the Varaha avatar. Varaha or Varaham means the pig. The god became pig incarnation, the third. Why they selected the pig is, the pig is very very older living being in this land. The fish can survive only in the water. The turtle can survive both in water and land. And the pig can survive only in the land. So now you can understand that how step by step they show us the evolution of the living beings. What is special in the pig is, why they selected it, though there are so many species in the land who can live only in the land, the selection had a big reason. All animals, they look for the food on the surface of the earth, like a deer, like a goat, cow, whatever, they down to the earth and they eat. But the pig, they also down to the earth and they eat, but further they will dig the land. Wherever they live, they will have a habit that always digging the land. How this habit came to the pig is, when the land is erupted by the volcanoes from the under of the ocean, the land is created, that time only few plants were started to arrive. That time many of the plants may have stored their stores, their seeds under the earth, like in their roots. So the pig had the chance mostly to eat their food only by digging the plants under the earth. So this habit is imprinted in the genes of the pig. So still it continues in their genes, and now wherever it is living, it always dig the land. So it started from the very old time. The next avatar is the Narasimha avatar. It is very very important avatar. We have to discuss in detail about this, and many natural secrets are hidden in this avatar. What is Narasimha? Nara means human, Simha means lion, avatar incarnation, a human lion incarnation. In this story, a standing man, but he has a lion head. He is called Narasimha. He evolved. This Narasimha character is a mixture of animals and human. So this is the point where the human beings started to evolve. Now let's go to see the Charles Darwin theory. He says that we humans evolved from the monkeys. Now there is another question. Okay, we evolved from the monkeys, the apes like that. But now also the apes, the monkeys are living in this world. Why the human beings are not coming from the apes now? There is no answer for this question for Charles Darwin or anywhere in this world. Maharishi explains clearly, scientifically. He says, yes, we came from the monkeys, the apes who are tailless, but we came not only from the monkeys. We were a cross product of two animals. The one is the monkey, another one is called Leo. In Tamil, it is called Yali. Yali in Tamil, in Sanskrit or in Hindi, it's called a Leo or lion in English. Because there was a lion, it is very bigger than the current lion. Like you can understand that how is the difference between the cat and the tiger. This is small and tiger is big. Similarly, the lion is small and the Leo is big, that is the Yali. It was very crucial animal. It will kill on its own children and it will eat away. There was an accidental mating between this crucial Yali, crucial Leo, a male Leo, and a female tailless monkey, that is called a ape. So by this action, a cross product came. That cross product is called Narasimha. If you see the picture of Narasimha, you can see a standing lion will be. It means his father is a Leo, it is a Yali, it is a lion family. His mother is a ape, this is a tailless standing monkey. So he is a cross product. Now the wonder is this Narasimha had a reproducing ability and he again lived with the family of the female monkeys. Because he was a child of a monkey, so who will raise that child? The same monkey, mother monkey will die. So when this Narasimha grows up, when he attains the maturity, he had the reproducing ability also. So he mated with the other female monkeys in that group. And we are the children of that family. So the Narasimha is the forefather of all the human population of this current world. Now we have to discuss the consciousness of the Almighty here. In the nature, generally the cross mating will not happen. Though the cross mating will happen, the female will not get conceived. Even if the female get conceived and it gets a child, that child when it grows up, it will not have a reproducing ability. So this is the fixed rule in the nature by the consciousness of the Almighty. Human cannot break this, but God can break this own rule. If you see the nature, some cross matings will happen occasionally. A dog will mate with other living beings also in this world, but it will not get conceived. This is the first rule which we cannot break. Thus, in second, in some cases it will get conceived. For example, if a horse and a donkey, if they mate, it will get conceived. A child will come. That child is called a mule. It will have both characters of horse and the donkey. But the mules cannot have the reproducing ability. So it cannot produce a new generation. So up to the second rule, we can see in the nature, they are naturally broken in some cases. But the third case, the cross product comes and it has the reproducing ability. It is very impossible, though we research in the genes. But God can break his own rule, and the Narasimha came as a cross product of lion and the monkey, and he had the reproducing ability and he lived with the female monkeys, and we are the children of those families. Now let's research on our human characters. We came from monkeys. Means monkeys are vegetarian. Why do we, most of the people, they eat non-vegetarian? Because we have the genetical imprints of the lion, the Leo also. So it is a non-vegetarian animal, so that character also are imprinted with us. So we eat both vegetarian and non-vegetarian, from monkey and lion both. And another one, if you see in the lion family, only the male lion will have the beard and mustache, the female lioness not. This character continues in our genes. That is why the men have the beard and mustache and the women don't. Like this point, so many characters from the monkeys and Leos are inherited in our soul, and we are living, or most of the people living, with the animal characters. Our Sky Yoga has the power to eradicate these animal imprints, and we can live an actual human being. Next, we see the next avatar. It is called Vamana avatar. Now we can see in the picture that a small human will be. He has an umbrella above his head. This is the first man. In this picture, in this story, why they selected a small human is the human beings started to evolve from the Narasimha and they are living. But a small family started, that family, they resorted to the mountains, the hills area. When a people, the persons, they live in the mountains, their heights will possibly come less. This is the nature of the mountains. If you see the Japanese and the Chinese, why they are smaller? Because they are living in the hills area. So this is the nature. So what is the secret there? The hills and the height. Yes. Once there was a question asked to our Maharishi, why the people differ in the colors and the height? Like Africans, they are more black, and Europeans, they are white, and Chinese, they are smaller, like that. Maharishi says that this came not only by the climate or temperature. They also play the role, but not the only factors there. But in addition, the sun radiations, they penetrate the earth and they travel inside. There are chemicals and minerals, metals under the earth. So when the sun radiations penetrate and they clash on these metals and minerals, and that minerals and metals emit the radiations, and that radiations comes out, that radiation has the power to change the color of the surface people and the height or about extra further more factors. So in the mountains, especially in the mountains, the minerals, chemicals and metals under the mountains, their radiations have the ability to reduce the height of the living beings on the surface. Not only the humans, we see the camels. There are two hump camels living in the China and Mongolia and Kashmir also, you can see. They will be very smaller than the Rajasthan camel with one hump. So the living beings has less height because of the mountains. In the beginning, the first family or the smallest population, they lived in the hills area, mountain area, to survive from the natural disasters like flood, earthquake, like that. So their height became less. The next avatar is called the Parasurama. Parasurama avatara, if you see in that picture, he will be a taller person, and he had a instrument with the iron piece. This shows the human discovered the use of the metal, the steel, the iron. Before, if you see in the Vaman avatara, he has an umbrella. The umbrella shows that his knowledge develops to protect himself from the nature. So he uses the leaves of the plants, the trees, and he makes an umbrella and he protects himself. And next, the Parasurama has the iron piece. So he discovered the iron, the steel, and he made the weapons, and he destroyed the forest, and he created the land. This Parasurama will be a taller person. Now we can understand that why he is taller, because the smallest population from the hills area, they come to the surface and they live in the normal land, and by nature, this land's nature and the chemicals, metals, minerals under the earth, their radiations, they don't affect the height of the people, and he automatically grows taller. This is the nature. Next, the next avatar is Rama avatar. Rama was a king. He was ruling a country. So the king, the kingdom, the ruling all shows the society. The human being was a small population living in the hills area, and they came down and they destroyed the forest, and they created the land, and they used the land further. They unite more. When the more people unite, the administration come. So administration and the ruler, the administration. So this kind of intellectual or knowledge, the cultural evolution is indicated in the Rama avatar. This Rama avatar not only means the cultural evolution. Further, they have some yogic concepts also. What comes in the story? The Rama and his wife Sita and Ravana. The Ravana has 10 heads, and he abducted the Sita and took to the Sridanga. And Rama strives to rescue her, and he succeeded. So this was the story. What is the yogi concept is, the Rama is the Paramatma, that is the Almighty, that is the God. The Sita is the soul, that is our self, the life force of each living being in this world. This property, this soul, our life force is the property which has to resort to the God, the Almighty, the Rama. But what happens? A ten-headed, the Ravana abducts this Sita. It means that ten heads indicates our Karma Indriyas and the Jnana Indriyas. We know in the spiritual path what are the Karma Indriyas and the Jnana Indriyas. These are the 5 plus 5 and 10 Indriyas, senses in our body, and our Karma Indriyas and the Jnana Indriyas, these 10 Indriyas, they abduct our soul and they separate our soul from the Almighty, and they take our soul to the worldly enjoyments, and finally what will happen, the pains and miseries will result. This is what in the Rama story. What happens in the climax? The Rama takes efforts to rescue from the Ravana, and again he accomplishes the Sita. It means, though our ten senses, the Indriyas, they rule our soul, the God, the Almighty, always supply with his love and compassion. He sends the Guru and he gives the practice, meditation, Kundalini, Yoga, everything. When we do that, all our Karma Indriyas and Jnana Indriyas will come to under our control. So automatically, they will not affect us. So as a result, what will happen? By regular meditation, regular yoga, regular meditation, what will happen? We will get the wisdom and enlightenment. This is what the Sita reaches the Rama. The next avatar is Balarama avatar. The Balarama avatar indicates the further evolution. This Balarama has a pluff on his shoulder. It indicates the development of agriculture. The Parasurama had a iron metal, and he destructed the forest and he created the land, and the country came. And thereafter, people live comfortably and the society comes. And there is the Rama, the kingdom, king, ruler, everything. And further, the agriculture evolution is indicated in this Balarama avatar. The next evolution, next incarnation is the Krishna avatar. The Krishna avatar full and full indicates the nature of the Almighty. What means Krishna? In Sanskrit, the word Krishnam means black. Beyond the universe, we say the Almighty is a absolute dark space. So God is dark. They indicate through the word Krishna. Krishna means a dark man. It means the God is dark. It is absolute dark space. And in Krishna avatar, when the Krishna was child, we know a famous story that he was stealing the butter, and his mother will arrest him, and she will check him to show his mouth, and he will open his mouth, and his mother will wonder that she saw a biggest universe in the mouth of the Krishna. There is a big natural secret, or the nature or character of the Almighty is described here. The biggest universe is inside the God, inside the absolute dark space. So Krishna is the black man, it is the absolute dark space, and the universe is inside. As we Kundalini yogis, we know very well that this whole universe is inside the absolute dark space, which is boundaryless. So the same concept is described in this story, that the whole universe is inside the God. Next, When the Krishna grows up, he is playing with the girls of the village. Many people, they wrongly misinterpret that Krishna did this kind of misbehavior. No, it is not a misbehavior. The Krishna was a Paramatma. Like how was the Rama Paramatma and Sita was Jivatma. Here, the Krishna as Paramatma and all the other girls who lived in that village are the Jivatmas. It means the 800 crore current population are the gopis, the girls of that village. So they all gopis, the girls, they like to resort to the Krishna. It means all the humans, we try to reach the God. We try to merge with the God. So this thought, this concept is described that the girls, they liked, they desired, and they took the efforts, and Krishna also played the role with them. This Krishna avatar explains mostly the cause and effect system and the love and compassion of the nature, the Almighty, everything. For example, in the Kurukshetra war, at the final climax, the Arjuna, he worries very well that, oh, I killed my guru, the Drona, and I killed my brothers and the others. That time, Krishna told that, don't worry, Arjuna, just go to a mountain, and he showed a mountain, and go and reach there, and ask the same question, and he will explain you what happened actually. And Arjuna will go to the mountain, and when he went there, there was a head only. He said, who are you? Arjuna said, I was asking a question that I was worrying that I killed my brothers and my guru, and Krishna sent me here. Who are you? I was a giant. I was killed by Krishna, but I asked a bone that I wanted to see the Kurukshetra war. And he granted that boon, and now I was watching that. Okay, what is your problem? I worry a lot that I killed my guru and my brothers. And that giant, that headed giant said that, I never saw you in the war field, in the battle. Only the Krishna, he sent out that chakra, that wheel, and it killed the Drona. It killed the Duryodhana and all other Gauravas. Who were you? I never saw you in the war field. That time, Arjuna got consoled a lot, and he realized that all are the actions of the Almighty, that Krishna. Here, this concept, this story concept, resembles with our Vedatri Maharishi concept. What our Maharishi says, a person, all persons cannot inflict pain to others on their own desires. Every person has the negative imprint, that means the sinful imprints on their genetic center. When this genetic center imprints, the sinful imprints comes to get carried out by the nature, automatically the nature utilizes the other people who have the thought of killing the others or torturing the others, inflicting the pains others. So nature's duty is to clean our genetic center. At the same time, the nature should give the opportunity to the others who never destroyed their bad thoughts. So nature connects both these, and nature cleans out our soul from the negative sinful imprints by employing the other person through it. So this is what happens in our life, why the other people give pains and miseries to us. The same, they didn't give pains and miseries through their, they are coming in the picture only. They are an arrows only. The bow is somewhere else. That somewhere else bow is our sinful genetic center. Our sinful imprints, they use as an instrument the other people, and that people come and they clean our genetic center by giving the pain, the miseries, everything. Now we have to say thanks to them. Similarly, the sinful imprints of Drona, the sinful imprints of the Duryodhana all came out. There was a time. So that time, Arjuna had a thought to rescue his land. He never had a bad thought, but had the situation that to rescue his land only by fighting, by killing these people. So here the thought and their imprints came out that. So both are connected, and the Krishna, the Almighty, the consciousness uses this Arjuna as an instrument. But through the Arjuna, Krishna only cleansed the genetic center of the negative people, that Duryodhana, all the other things. Next, the last avatar is the Kalki avatar. So by explaining this, we finish our today class. Next, the Kalki avatar. All the nine incarnations came, people believe so. But the Kalki avatar is yet to come. What is Kalki avatar? In the Kalki avatar picture, you can see a man will come in a horse of a white color. A white color horse and a human will be. It indicates the philosophy of magnetism. In our culture, wherever you see the white color, it indicates the pure magnetic power. There was a saint called Mahakavi Bharatiyar. He was a contemporary saint, lived with the Maharishi's time, and he says in a poem that உள்ளும் புறமும் உள்ளதெல்லாம் தானாகும் வெள்ளம் ஒன்று உண்டாம் அதை தெய்வம் என்பர் வேதியரே. மகரிஷி எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ஸ் த வேர்ட் வெள்ளம் ஹியர். த வேர்ட் வெள்ளம் மீன்ஸ் வெல் பிளஸ் அம். வெல் மீன்ஸ் வெண்மை ஆர் த பியூர் ஒயிட். அம் மீன்ஸ் த மேக்னெட்டிக் பவர். எ பியூர் மேக்னெட்டிக் பவர் இஸ் ப்ரெசன்ட் ஆல் ஓவர் த யூனிவர்ஸ். திஸ் வாட் த மகாகவி பாரதியார் எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ஸ். தட் பியூரிட்டி, that purity is indicated here through the white color, that white horse. The human is all human beings. So Kalki avatar is the discovery of the magnetic power, for example the electricity. When this electricity was discovered, that was the arrival time of the Kalki avatar. For example, before 100 years this electricity was discovered by the scientists in Europe. So that is the time that Kalki avatar started to emerge. So the human traveling in the white horse indicates that all humans will come to know what is the magnetic power, and they will utilize the magnetic power from the electricity up to the Brahmanyana. The electricity, by using the magnetic power, you can live comfortably by using the electrical instruments, everything. Not only the enjoyments, up to the enlightenment also you can use by the magnetic power. Maharishi also will explain that by using the magnetic power, we can explain the God concept, the Brahmanyanam concept very clearly. So the Kalki avatar started to emerge before 100 years also. So further in the science, whatever the people, the scientists discover more and more instruments, more and more concepts, more and more magnetic concepts, more and more God theory, whatever they discover, all are indicated by using the single picture that a man is traveling the white horse. It means humans will travel, they will reach their destination by using the magnetic. What is our destination? Our destination is the wisdom, the enlightenment. We have to reach the God. That travel, that destiny can be easily achieved by the traveling in the white horse. That is called, by utilizing the magnetic power, magnetic philosophy, people can realize the God from the worldly enjoyments up to the Almighty. People can live comfortably and also very perfectly. This is what the Kalki avatar expects. Okay friends, so this is the evolution of living beings and the universe described through the stories by our forefathers in the Dasavatara. So from the fish up to the horseman, the Kalki avatar, all the natural evolution, culturally evolution, magnetic evolution, everything, and the cause and effect, everything. So we go to finish our today discussion, and we hereby take a vote to respect and to prize the knowledge, the consciousness of our forefathers who lived in this land thousands of years ago, who had realized the value of the Almighty, value of the humans, and the evolution of universe and the living beings, everything. So thank you, friends. I hereby thank the WCCIT wing for giving a good opportunity to me. Thank you. Be blessed by the divine.